I'm here to listen to whatever you have to say.
I'm going to kill you, Father. I'm going to kill you because you're innocent. Not right now, though. I give you enough time to put your house in order, make your peace with God.
The word Calvary is about suffering for other people, on behalf of other people, taking the pain of other people and suffering through it for their sake.
Who would walk to their death? Who would go to meet a person who has promised to kill them? Well, Jesus did that.
In a lot of people's minds, a lot of Christians' minds, the word Calvary automatically connotates the last 7 days of Jesus' life, and specifically his crucifixion. Calvary, the film, follows this priest over 7 days of his life as he moves to a place where he is faced with a choice to essentially sacrifice himself or to turn away.
You've got a man who's essentially good, going against the current and trying to stick to his ideals. And it's not necessarily the ideology of the church.
There's a man who believes in such good values in a church that sometimes has misunderstood what those things mean.
What you have are the people in the Gospels. We're seeing them in this town. Because wherever we go, we encounter the same population that Jesus encountered. People who are trying hard, people who are failing, and other people who are searching.
So you're sure there's a God then, Father? Yeah. I'm asking because I'm having doubts myself, like, I'm having a crisis of faith.
You're supposed to be a beacon of hope, so then they go to the beacon of hope and then they throw muck at it to see can they put it out.
That don't be going away, Matt. I'm an awful messer.
But that's the struggle, is to keep shining through it. And sometimes it becomes almost impossible, but this guy keeps going.
Janine, get in the car. What were you saying to her?
I wasn't saying anything to her.
Father James's burden, I think, is two things. I think he carries the burden of a broken church on one shoulder, and I think he carries the burden of a broken world on the other. And I think he's trying to somehow heal both of those and trying to use one broken system to heal another broken system.
Run along now, Father. Your sermon is finished.
At some stage, I began to think, this character can't take any more. And then there would be a very beautiful line where, for example, Marie Jose Crozet's character comes to his rescue almost in an angel-like fashion, that she has suffered a horrible loss. And her faith, her insistence on it, insistence on love, helps him when he's at a very, very low ebb.
What is faith? For most people, it's the fear of death, nothing more than that. If that's all it is, it's very easy to lose.
It must not have been much of a fate to begin with, if it is so easy for them to lose it.
There's so many areas it touches upon, you know, faith, what it means to be a decent person. Are there some things which cannot be forgiven?
They say charges are going to be filed against me for various so-called irregularities. And we all know full well that's not going to happen. No, there'll be no punishment forthcoming for a man such as myself. There never is.
These big, big questions. And the film does it in a very, very challenging, interesting way.
Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned.
Say one Our Father and 10 Hail Marys.
I've sinned more than that.
There's a lot of sin in this town, and he knows it, but he does know that the opposite of sin is virtue, is that power to be good.
I think there's too much talk about sins, to be honest. Not enough talk about virtues.
You might be right. What would be your number one?
I think forgiveness has been highly underrated.
He's not perfect by any means, but by the end, he believes in forgiveness and he believes in love and he believes in hope, which is the triumph of it.